गुड मॉर्निंग क्लास फाइव. टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू हैव आर टेस्ट ऑन चैप्टर नंबर 1 एंड 2. ओके, सो बिफोर दैट वी हैव अ क्विक रिविजन ऑफ चैप्टर नंबर 1 एंड 2. द फर्स्ट चैप्टर इज अबाउट जनरेशंस ऑफ कंप्यूटर्स. सो वी ऑलरेडी हैड वन टेस्ट ऑन जनरेशंस ऑफ कंप्यूटर्स, राइट? सो गोइंग थ्रू द चैप्टर, अ क्विक रिविजन, वॉट इज अ जनरेशन. द वे वी हैव in our families, we have father and then grandfather and then great grandfather, right? So that is the generation in our family. Same way computers have a history. Okay, so there was initially the computers were big and used lot of power, then produced lot of heat, then it developed into and the size of the computers were like a size of a 10-storied building, a size of a 5-storied building, okay, something equivalent to that. Then the systems did not have the keyboards, the systems did not have the monitors. They used to be operated by special people who were trained for that, and it was not available for normal business, okay. Later the size was reduced, then the power consumption was less, and the heat produced was less, and it was released for commercial use, as in we can use it at home, we can use it in the shops. As and when the generations and the development happened, okay, and improvements happened, we got computers. So today we have computers size of a hand, right? So something which we can actually carry in the pocket. We can actually be traveling with a laptop, we can be traveling with a tablet PC. So this is called the generations of computer. Generation means remarkable improvement, okay. First generation computers, 1946 to 58, and used vacuum tubes. So the vacuum tubes look something like this, okay. The size was very big, operating speed was very slow, very expensive. Okay, ENIAC and UNIVAC are the examples of the first generation computers. So what were the drawbacks? It produced lot of heats and was not reliable. Not reliable, reliable ka kya matlab hai? Jo result aata hai, tha, us par hum trust nahi kar sakte the ki wo actually mein bilkul sahi hai ki nahi hai. Okay, then next is it used machine language, which is a low-level programming language. Okay, UNIVAC is the first commercial computer delivered to a business client. Commercial computer, that means which can be used in a business or to do some research work and things. Then the second generation computers, 1959 to 1964, it used transistors. Now transistors looks something like this. We have already drawn in our notebooks, we have done this activity. Okay, the second generation, in the first generation the language was machine language, the second generation assembly language instead of machine language, and the few computers systems which were released were IBM 140, Mark III and Leo. Okay, features that the size was smaller than that of the first generation and the operating speed was faster. The cost got reduced. Drawbacks, again, they used to produce a lot of heat, speed was still slow, and the memory was less. Next is the third generation, 1965 to 1970, and the component for the third generation was integrated circuits, okay, also known as semiconductor chips. Now semiconductor is the material which was used to make these chips, okay. The third generation computers could carry billions of instructions in a few seconds, so speed was good, speed was better than that of first and second generation. The size of these computers were so small that they could fit into a small file cabinet. So compared to the first and the second generation, the first generation computers were building size. So the third generation computers were cupboard size. Okay, cabinet means cupboard. Examples are IBM 360, ICL 1900 and CDC, etc. Features, the size was smaller, they were more reliable. Users interacted with keyboards and monitors which interfaced with an operating system. So first thing is that an operating system existed, then a keyboard and a monitor were used. They generated lesser heat and high level language like COBOL and FORTRAN was used. Okay. And fourth generation computers, 1971 onwards, the computers that we use today, that is personal computers, desktops, laptops, they are all fourth generation computers. Okay. Intel 4004, Macintosh, IBM 370 are few of the examples, and the languages are C, C++ and Java. The fourth generation computers were so small that they could fit on small desk or palm of the hand. Features, they used microprocessor, they are multipurpose computers, they are accurate and reliable. Accurate ka matlab bahut sahi result deta hai, theek hai na? Accurate ka matlab error nahi karta hai, bilkul sahi result deta. The operating speed was very fast. A microprocessor is a small chip that does all the processing in a computer. Integrated circuit is a small electronic device made out of semiconductor material. Integrated circuit IC is also called a chip, and the first IC was developed in 1950 by Jack Kilby and Robert Nice. Fifth generation computers, artificial intelligence is the component, and the main goal of fifth generation is to develop computers that can respond to natural language. So, jaise humne already ye padha hai that when we say okay Google, what is the capital of India? Okay, the question that we ask, the similar answer we get. The capital of India is New Delhi. So, it is actually responding to natural language, human speech. Okay, Alexa, please play this song from this movie. So Alexa can play that song for you. These are all examples of fifth generation, and this comes under, they are based on artificial intelligence. Okay, so we have studied the first, second, third, fourth, fifth generation and the components, the year in which these computers, the period of the computers, okay, the period of the generation.